massive river of lava is moving down Kilauea volcano on Hawaii's Big Island as the ongoing eruption intensifies, forcing more people out of their homes and injuring at least one man. Hawaii County civil defense officials said that late Saturday night a lava flow moving at 300 feet per hour reached Highway 137, one of the main highways in the Puna district. A section of the road was shut down. The officials also reported that a lava flow had reached the Pacific Ocean. Lava entering the water creates lase, a type of volcanic gas that may endanger nearby residents. Lase is formed when hot lava makes contact with the ocean, sending hydrochloric acid, steam and fine glass particles into the air. Brush fires caused by the lava forced the agency to ask residents on Kamele Road to evacuate the area immediately on Saturday around 6:40 p.m. local time. County and state firefighters were going door to door in that area informing residents of the evacuation and assisting them when necessary. Everyone needs to stay clear of this area, the agency said. The flows began forming on May 3rd, after several fissures opened up in the Lalani Estates subdivision of Puna, located on the volcano's lower east rift zone. Since then, at least 44 structures have been consumed by lava, including dozens of homes. On Friday, lava engulfed four more homes and a flow from fissure 20 crossed a part of Pahoiki Road, near Malamaki Place, cutting access to a remote neighborhood with 40 homes. As a result, four people had to be evacuated, according to officials. Over the past 2 weeks, an estimated 1,700 residents have been evacuated from Lalani Estates and neighboring Lainapuna Estates subdivisions. The U.S. Geological Survey's Hawaiian Volcano Observatory, which has been monitoring the eruption, said that several fissures have merged to form a continuous line of spatter and fountain in an update sent Saturday afternoon. Hawaii County Civil Defense Administrator Talmadge Magno said at a news conference Saturday afternoon that one man sustained a serious injury after a spatter of lava hit his leg while he was sitting on the porch of a house earlier in the day. The lava bomb hit his leg and he got injured, Magno told reporters. The injury was quite bad. Aerial footage of the lava shows several large flows from a number of fissures swallowing the land in a fiery, loud and explosive display. Janet Williams Downing, a resident of Nanuela Estates, a few miles north of Lalani Estates, told HuffPost that she has been feeling about 100 earthquakes every day with a little shake every once in a while. You can hear the explosions from the fissures, Williams Downing told HuffPost in a message. It sounds like a war zone right outside my door. Williams Downing said that the explosions and sound similar to that of jet engines are normal now that numerous fissures have been cracking open and spewing lava for nearly 2 weeks. It was scary at first with all the explosions and not knowing which way the lava was going to go, she said. A crater on Kilauea's summit erupted with a giant ash plume on Thursday, launching ash and volcanic debris up to 30,000 feet high. As expected, more eruptions followed and on Saturday, another large ash plume could be seen exploding from the Halemaumau crater. Earlier Saturday, Hawaii County Civil Defense asked residents between Kamele Road and Pahoiki Road, located southwest of Lalani Estates, to decide whether they wanted to voluntarily leave the area. Officials believe the active flows are headed in the general direction of Mackenzie State Park, located on the island's eastern coast.
side of the fence.